A principal economist of S&P Global believes the U.S. is likely to cut its borrowing rates. Harumi Taguchi says America's inflation print and unemployment data makes it more likely for the Federal Reserve to lower rates in September. She adds analysts are all keeping an eye on Jerome Powell's Jackson Hole speech to see whether the Fed chair will give any clues on rate reduction. Meanwhile, Harumi notes the Philippines' growth of 6.3% for the second quarter is much better than its Southeast Asian peers. She, however, warns the private sector is contributing to slower quarter-on-quarter growth. Harumi says the central bank's recent decision to cut interest rates by 25 basis points is a sound decision for the long run.
Rate cut is probably a good call for the sustainable growth. I think it is possibly the December is the next rate cut, but as if the inflation data is more softening than we currently expected.
The Philippine Senate approves on third and final reading the proposed Blue Economy Act. That bill adopts a blue economy as a framework for the sustainable and safe use and development of marine wealth for economic growth while building resilience to climate change. It will form the Blue Economy Council, which will formulate an integrated strategy to strengthen, grow, and sustain the Philippines' blue economy. The World Bank defines blue economy as the sustainable use of ocean resources for economic growth while preserving the health of the ocean ecosystem. Goldman Sachs lowers its odds for a U.S. recession to 20%, coming from 25%. It cites recent data that were better than expected. The U.S. last week reported retail sales rose 1% in July versus estimates of a 0.3% growth, while weekly jobless claims fell to a one-month low. Goldman Sachs earlier this month raised its U.S. recession probability to 25% following a weak jobs report. J.P. Morgan followed days after, raising fears about the world's biggest economy and helping trigger a sharp stock market sell-off. Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of defense companies, including Rheinmetall, Bay Systems, and Assault Aviation, as Germany plans to rein in new military aid for Ukraine. Also in focus, shares of Danish biotech firm Zealand Pharma, after its CEO told Reuters last week it is looking for a big pharma partner to help bring its weight loss drug to the market. The stock fell 4.5%. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of AMD after it announced plans to acquire server maker ZT Systems for nearly $5 billion. Shares of the chipmaker rose 3% in the pre-market. Asian markets ended Monday trade mostly higher ahead of central bank decisions and inflation data. The Nikkei 225, however, slumped 1.8% following an unexpected drop in Japan's machinery orders. Here at home, Philippine shares booked gains as local investors stayed risk on following last week's BSP rate cut.
Happy to say that we're kind of closer to our forecast now, going past 6.8 and actually holding that as new support will bring us to a newer consolidation high of maybe 7.4. So I think that would be a base to optimistic forecast for us. Our long-term price chart is now positive, considering all of those positive convergent factors that was mentioned earlier. And we think it's a buy on dip opportunity, especially for very underappreciated stocks and sectors.
Some notable stock movements in the region: 7-Eleven operator 7&I Holdings saw its share soar over 22% or their daily trading limit. That's on news it has received a preliminary takeover offer from Canada's Alimentation Couche-Tard. Meanwhile, Australia's Westpac Bank reported steady third-quarter profit growth thanks to higher capital earnings. Shares of Australia's third-biggest bank closed 2.5% higher.